Hello, boys and girls. This is Miss Pan from 2S. Today, I'll continue with Module 4. And let's see what we are going to learn today. Number 1. Opposite adjectives about people's characters. We'll talk more about this. And then we'll learn the negative form of verbs. That is, do not and does not. After that, we'll do task 17 together. So, are you ready now? Okay, if you still remember, you have learned a lot of good adjectives. And the first one is about people's appearance. How do they look? Like tall, fat, and beautiful. And the second type of adjectives you have learned is about people's feelings. How do they feel? Like thirsty, angry, and tired. And today, we're going to talk more about people's characters. For example, helpful, hardworking, and kind. So how about you? Do you remember the adjectives about people's characters? Can you name some examples? All right, I'm going to show you some pictures. You're going to describe the people in the pictures by using some adjectives. Are you ready now? Number one, look at this boy. Wow, the toys are so nice in his room. So he tidies his room every day. What adjective can we use? Yes, tidy. And then the second one. Oh, the boy is very quiet. He does the revision every day. So what is the adjective we can use? Yes, hardworking. Let's move on. Look at the boy. He says please and thank you. What adjective can we use? Yes, that is polite. And how about the girl? She breaks a glass and she tells mom about it. And we look at another side. How about this boy? The boy asks, Michael? And he says, no. He tells lies. When we come back to this girl, she does not tell lies. So, how can we talk about her? Yes, honest. Let's look at the next one. Wow, what is the boy doing? He's cleaning the table. He helps at home. What can we talk about him? Yes, he's helpful. And how about the next one? Oh, the girl. She's doing a good job. She shares things with others. And here, how can we talk about her? Let Miss Pan teach you a new adjective. That is generous. Generous. That means shares things with others. Wow, just now we've learned 6 adjectives. And they are tidy, hardworking, polite, honest, helpful, and generous. And these adjectives are talk about some people doing good job. Let's move on. All right, just now we've learned some adjectives like tidy. And how about this girl? Wow, what happened to the toys? They're everywhere. She does not tidy her room. In this case, she's doing something totally different with the boy tidy. So what can we talk about her? Yes, we can use the adjective untidy. And here, tidy and untidy are the opposite adjectives. That means they are totally different. And we can see here not telling the difference. Okay, let's see the next one. We have learned hardworking. And how about this boy? He's sitting on the sofa. He's watching TV. And her mom is so angry about him. He does not do his homework. Then what is the opposite adjective? Yes, he is lazy. Oh no. Let's move on. Just now, this boy is polite. And how about this boy? He takes away the balloon and then just go. He does not say please and thank you. Oh, he is doing something very different from polite. So we can use the adjective rude to talk about the meaning. And these are the opposite adjectives. All right, let's move on. Just now, this girl is honest. And how about this boy? He doesn't talk about the car. He tells lies. So the opposite adjective can be dishonest. Yes. Let's move on. Let's see the next one. You remember this boy is helpful. And how about this boy? Oh, he is sitting on the sofa and his mom is so busy. He does not help at home. What can we talk about him? Maybe we can use this adjective, unhelpful. And these two are the opposite adjectives. That means that it's totally different. How about the girl? She's generous. And the boy? He's eating a cake and he does not share things with others. So we can use the word selfish. Okay, let's learn together. Selfish, that means does not share things with others. And these two, generous and selfish, are the opposite adjectives again. Okay, again, just now, we learned another six adjectives, and this time, these adjectives are about people's characters, but those which are not good things, like untidy, lazy, rude, dishonest, helpful, and selfish. Now, let's see how to use these opposite adjectives to make sentences. Let's use this example again. He tidies his room every day. First of all, the boy, we use he, that is third person singular verb. So for the verb T-I-D-Y, tidy, we need to change it to I-E-S, tidies. And the second one is, it's talking about the room of this boy. So we can use the possessive adjective his to talk about it. And how about next one? The girl. She is doing something totally different. She does not tidy her room. And in this case, for she or he, we need to use does not for third person singular again. And we don't change the action verbs like tidy in does not sentence. And that is very important. So these are the rules you have to pay attention. Let's see one more example. Here, the boy, he tells lies. Again, for he, she, it, third person singular verb, we use it in forms of like here with s, tells. And for next case, for the girl, for she does not tell lies. Again, for she, we use does not. And remember, after does not, we don't change it. We need to keep it T-E-L-L, tell. So we have, she does not tell lies. So you have to remember these rules. Let's review what we have learned just now. We have come across with a list of opposite adjectives about people's characters. Then we learned how to use the negative form of verbs, do not and does not, to make the sentence to talk about them. Now, we're going to do task 17 together. So boys and girls, take out your task book and turn to task 17 and get ready with your pencil. Now we're going to do this part. Let's have a close look of part A first. Part A, let me read the instruction. Follow the example to rewrite the sentences. So the first example, a hardworking person studies every day. So we have to write the opposite sentence. That's why for the first rule, we need to think about the opposite adjectives. Hardworking, the opposite one is lazy. Then the second one, you have to think about third person singular verb. For the word person here, it can be he or she. That's why for study, study, we need to change to studies. And that makes the sentence. So for rewriting the sentence, we need to write like this. A lazy person does not study every day. Because after does not, we do not change the action verb. So we keep study here. Let's see question one, and we'll do it together. A dishonest person tells lies. If you remember the rules, first, we have to think about the opposite adjective of dishonest, and that is honest. And the second one, for person, he or she, we need to change tell to the third person singular verb, that is with S, tells. And the third rule, remember, okay, when we rewrite the sentence in the opposite one, we do not change the action verb. But one more thing you have to be careful, because honest, the sound starts with the vowel, so we cannot use A, we cannot use A, we have to use N. So it should be an honest person does not tell lies. Okay, so with these two examples, I hope you can know how to finish the other question 2, 3, and 4. You're going to do it on your own. After you finish it, you can move on to part B. That is part B. Add more supporting details to make better sentences. Here, let's see the example. Ken tidies his desk. And then we want to make it more better with more information. Then we will ask, where? How often? So to make it a better sentence, we will say, Ken tidies his desk in his bedroom and every week. That answers the question where and how often. Okay, now there are two questions here. I want you to try to write your answers using the one given. And for number two, you have to think about your own where and how often. Okay, so that is all about it today. Finish task 17, part A and B. If you want to learn more, you can watch this video again. So that's all for today. And I'm Miss Pan. See you.